V6 and Strata WebView proudly present Uinta Basin High School basketball coverage in high definition. Season coverage is sponsored by Ashley Regional, CrossFit Avenue, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, Pilot Logistics Services, and the Advisor Group.
Good evening and welcome everybody to another VTV production of High School Basketball Action. We're here in Duchesne while the Duchesne Eagles host the Manila High School Mustangs. And the Eagles controlled the tip, took about 45 seconds off the game clock. Weren't able to convert Mustangs quickly the other way. And this is interesting tonight. We've got the Mustangs all the way down from Manila, and they've got some big boys and some talent. And for such a small town, these guys look like and represent themselves well and can play basketball. Missed the shot there, and the Eagles come quickly up the other way. Matt Muir with the ball, and they're going to call travel right here in front of me. Matt Muir caught the ball and shuffled. It was 2.5 steps. Caused the turnover, ball quickly in. Number 11, Ben Rose, a senior, out to the wing. And the Mustangs, they have a cool-looking jersey. It almost looks like it's got a collar on it with the black and white. And then, of course, this day and age, any shoe color or any sock color about goes. Eagles quickly across. Matt Muir with the ball in the corner. A little bit of spacing issues. Then off the backboard. Both teams rough here at the beginning, unable to do anything. Muir pokes it away. Bounces around, ultimately ends up Eagle ball. Last touched by Steele Handy, a senior for the Mustangs. Always love to come here to the Eagles home court. It's a beautiful facility. Want to remind you that tonight's game, and thank everyone that's watching the live stream and strata.tv. Also look for the rebroadcast Monday night on VTV Channel 6 and 706 High Definition. First points of the game, number 24, Braxton Spencer from the corner. The senior hits, and the corner three-pointer is one of the most dangerous shots on the floor. So hard to defend, and if played right, it spaces the defense out and stretches them to their maximum. And early, the Eagles make the Mustangs pay with the corner three. 3-0, 5:24 left here in the period. Dribble drive off his foot, goes to the shooter. That's number three, Daniel Raymond in the corner. He misses, ball bounces around. Then we get a foul. Ultimately, Ben Rose on the loose ball, Eagles ball.
Fouls on number 11, Ben Rose, his first, team's first.
Well, as the season winds down, we have the one more game. There's going to be up at Altamont. That'll be next Wednesday, tonight's game. And this is the first time I've been able to call the Mustangs in action, although I've seen them play. And strong Trent Roberts absorbs the contact and high off the glass and in. And the Eagles 5-0 lead the Manila Mustangs. Looking for an opening, nothing there. Swing it back around the side. And the Eagles' man-to-man defense is keeping the Mustangs out of the lane. Oh, nice power offensive rebound. Up and in. Beautiful play by Steele Handy. Handy with good closeout defense on the perimeter. Not able to get it. The quick passes. Roberts unable to convert underneath. Got himself too far underneath the backboard. And a lot of kind of helter-skelter there at the top of the half-court line. The Mustangs are lucky to maintain possession. Looking back and forth, and again, the Mustangs haven't been able to penetrate a lot in the middle. The 2 points they converted were on the offensive glass, Handy off the weak side. But right now, the man-to-man defense for the Eagles making it hard for the Mustangs to get into the offense. And then a trap up the top, and he goes up and misses the layup, but fouled. Number 5, Matt Gonder with the foul. And he's going to put Alex Gatherum on the line, the 6-foot senior trying to go off the left side with his left hand, and it's so difficult. You've got a guy breathing down your neck, and even though Gatherum is a natural lefty, it's hard to gather and take that contact on that full sprint. Makes the first free throw. We got some early substitutions. Saldana, number four for the Eagles, comes in. For the Mustangs. Gatherum gets up and makes the second with the soft touch in the left hand. And it's so rare you see a left-hander, and then he's smooth and natural with that hand too. Makes it hard on the defender. They're not used to guarding people with a left-handed touch. Breaks him down, gets to the corner. Looks good. Oh, just a hair long. And here come the Eagles, beating everyone down the court. Number 15, Blake Jones, knocked out of bounds. The Eagles get into their set play off the out of bounds. Looked at you, get it in quickly to Roberts. Stripped. They pass the ball right to me here in the corner. Eagles ball again. Good quick hands from the Mustangs. Got the zone defense. It looks like kind of a 2-3. Quick penetration by Gatherum. Finds the hole in the defense and hits the nice 15-foot jumper. Got a timeout for the Mustangs. With a 9-2 lead, I think that's the right call. Coach Rusty Burnside says, hey, we're kind of getting run off the court here, and it's just a hustle difference. He's going to reset his charges, hopefully try to gather that back together. We've got tonight's game is sponsored by the Advisor Group, financial planning, benefit packages, insurance or retirement plans. We have a specialized team to help meet your needs. We are the firm of firms, the Advisor Groups. There's Coach Billy Hoops getting his charges set. I kind of like to come to the Eagles' home court. I kind of think of this place as like championship high. There's more championship banners up in the rafters here than I think any other high school in the basin. And we were fortunate enough this year to be to the Eagles championship football game up at Weber State. It was a tremendous amount of fun. Looking for passes. Gather him with the steal, but can't gather it in. Knocks it out of bounds. Mustang ball on the sideline. Saldana screens over. Couple of screens. Another long three. Just long again. No offensive rebounders down. And quickly across half court, Braxton Spencer takes it all the way. Ball knocked out of bounds. Eagles possession. Doesn't look like the Eagles. Oh, and that's a nice play. You're going to see right there, Blake Jones started up on the high post and comes off a double screen, catches on the low left block and scores easily. Nobody up on the shooter. Missed again, and so far the three-pointers are not falling for the Mustangs. Matt Gonder missed the last one. Down in the corner to Hanberg. Reset their offense. A little bit of a spacing issue. They've got a little 3-2 going on here. Looks like a play UCLA always runs. They bring the two post out, try to clear, and then off the screen cutters. Again, trying to clear out that baseline, bringing both posts up high. An off-ball cutter's down to low to Roberts. He's dangerous there. Elects to kick it out to Gatherum. And then stolen by number 21, Steely Handy. And here come the Mustangs. Again, not a lot of interior action going on for the Mustangs right now. A no call on what would have easily been considered a flop. Ball bounces around. And Roberts with the rebound and quickly up court. Oh, and then just thrown out of bounds by Daniel Hamburg. He had the right idea. Gatherum was over here in the corner. but he couldn't gather it and get an accurate pass and go sailing high out of bounds. Saldana's going to bring up the ball, see what the Eagles are going to give him. No screens at the top, just a pass and screen down. Double screen up the top. Very little penetration. Again, 53 seconds left here in the period. And a quick period. Only two fouls called in the whole period, both against the Mustangs. Trying to get a good shot. There's a good look. He gets some penetration. Uses his body to draw the foul. And Braxton Spencer saying, what did I do? Looked like he jumped pretty much straight up. You're going to see on the replay, here he comes. Saldana gets the penetration. Spencer jumps straight up, and Saldana just kind of runs into him and draws the foul, gets himself two shots, misses the first one long. All of their shots have been a little bit too long. Sometimes you get out on the road, you're a little extra juiced up, and all those shots get a little long. That's been the Mustangs' curse tonight. 11-2, the Eagles lead here with 34 seconds left in the first period. Saldana misses both. The Eagles quickly across half court and then into their half court set. Penetration and, ooh, nice reverse, can't get it to go. That's Braxton Spencer. And with 10 seconds left, the Mustangs, have got to score here to kind of try to help even things out. Not sure if they're aware of the game clock. Saldana looks like he did understand it. Roberts goes up high and knocks the ball away, but it was an air ball, clearly. 11-2, the Duchesne Eagles lead the Manila Mustangs. We're going to take a break and hear a word from our sponsors.
Moon Lake Electric has been a staple in the basin for 75 years. And though many things have changed through the years, one thing stays the same. Our dedication to keeping the power on and our priority of doing that safely. We now have a Facebook page, which can be accessed through our website, allowing you to receive energy tips, outage reports, personnel changes, and feedback. Moon Lake Electric thanks its members and employees for 75 years of keeping the power on.
Welcome back, everybody. Mark Mason here with VTV Channel 6. The Duchesne Eagles hosting the Manila Mustangs. And in probably what has been the quickest quarter in my life, if you blinked, you missed it. Both teams running up and down the court, very little fouls. And the Eagles clearly dominated that first quarter, 11-2. One of the Eagles falls down. Boy, and the Mustangs just can't get anything to drop. You see right there, Daniel Raymond had a great look. Just couldn't get it to go down. A lot of off-ball cuts. Roberts gets the ball with some strength, goes up high over the top of Alex Brady and soft off the glass, and it's tough for a righty to shoot on that left side, but Roberts made it look easy. Oh, Ben Rose had some good penetration, looked for Alex Brady on the dump off, and he did what he had to. With the penetration, he drew the defense's eyes and one step in. Would have been a nice shot for Brady, just couldn't handle it out of bounds. Eagles again into their half-court set. Patiently waiting for a good shot to present itself. Again, that's kind of that UCLA look. Two posts coming up high, a screen out, and then an off-ball cutter back door. It's a nice play. It's helped move around. And, ooh, good penetration, little bounce pass. And I'll tell you what, Hamburg amongst the trees goes up and draws a foul. You know, Daniel Hamburg's only 5'10". You don't want to call the 5'10 person short. When you're around a bunch of six-footers, you feel short, but he gets himself a foul and then two shots. Just rims that one out. We see Garrett Tatman checking in for the first time tonight. Hamburg for the second, misses both of them. Rebound by the Mustangs, and here they come in a hurry. Probing, trying to find a hole. Nothing presents itself. Swings it clear across court, deep three, long again. Rebound, Mustangs miss the easy one. On the line is going to stay the Mustangs ball. You saw Ben Rose get the rebound. And sometimes when it's so easy, that's when you make the mistake and don't get the easy one to go down. Trying to post up, misses him. Back to Jordan Saldana. Boy, it's just good defense. Right there, it was 32, Matthew Dye, that's causing all the problems for the Mustangs. He doesn't get the rebound, and away the Mustangs go, galloping down the court. Diving on the floor and saving it to number 10, Matt Muir, and that's 40, Wyatt Riemond, a sophomore, 6'2", and you see why the sophomore's getting some run. He's got the all hustled.
We've got a timeout, Eagles.
Timeout. 30-second timeout. Initially, the referee pointed at himself, but they're going to give this timeout to the Duchesne Eagles. That's the coach that's called that timeout. Tonight's game is brought to you by CrossFit Avenue. Family and student discounts available. No matter your fitness level, if you have the desire, we can train you. CrossFit Avenue in Vernal. Rusty Burnside, head coach from Manila. I think he's talking about how they're just running them around in circles. You can see him making the circle motion. And they've got to be aware when those cutters are coming off that back door and the double screens and coming up in the lane. Because the Eagles tonight have caught the ball in many occasions in the paint. And as a defender, you just can't allow that. Mustangs playing a difficult, on the high school level, 3-2. Especially when you have somebody, you know, as strong as, and of course Roberts is not on the floor. And that's why right there, because you get number 21, Steel Handy, up too high. And then he gets beat easily, and there's no one else there to gather him in and block him. And he makes an easy 10-foot floater. Looking for the post down low. They don't send it in. They do get some inside look. Not able to do anything with it. Defense! 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 15-2 is the score. Mustangs have had their looks, they just haven't gotten in. A nice penetration pass. Oh, a good look there by number 21, Steel Handy. Can't get to it. And right in front of me, Daniel Raymond comes screaming across and knocks the ball out of bounds. Burnside giving the troops encouragement from there. Long three straight away, goes off the rim, up high. Saldana out to the corner, screens down, looks back for the ball. Got it inside, he's not looking to shoot, looking for a pass. Nobody on you, you might want to shoot that ball. Backing off the center, giving him 5 feet. Not looking for a shot at all. Eagles just waiting for him to make a mistake. They do. throw it long, but the Mustangs were back, and they're coming again. Try to press the advantage while the defense is out of position. Saldana gets cut off and swings it back out to the left side. Daniel Raymond had the ball for a moment. Got the poster in the bottom that says, just do it. Penetration, and could have been fouled by either number 42, Trent Roberts, or, and it was 15, Blake Jones. You see here, quick penetration with the left hand. Nice crossover, and then just goes in there, and sure enough, it was Blake Jones with the body. Roberts was clear of that. And it's just one of those nights for the Mustangs. You can't get anything to go. Got a timeout on the floor. Missed the first of two. 15-2. Tonight's game is brought to us by Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional has two locations, Vernal and Roosevelt. The Roosevelt Clinic offers full services lab, x-ray, women's health, including OB services. So as we get a peek into the coaches' huddles, and anyone that's played basketball a lot, you don't need to be told, you know what to do, but sometimes you just gotta hear it over and over again, and you get in the heat of the moment, and things get a little bouncy and skippy, and you get out of sorts, and the timeout's just, let's do what we practiced, get right back into it. And this game's not out of hand, but right now the Mustangs have got to find their touch with their shots. And again, another long shot, high off the rim. Rebound, and here come the Eagles in a hurry. And boy, do the Eagles like to run. Get it out to Roberts, and he's dangerous from there. Misses from the right side, ball on the floor. Mustangs with it, and it's a scramble. Roberts and Handy tie each other up. It's going to stay here on the Eagles side of the court. And this double screen, looks like they're just gonna try to get to Roberts. They do, from the right, left side misses, but he gets the tip. Goes up high and taps it in with the right hand. Roberts having a fine night of basketball. Boy, and all the Eagles shots, or excuse me, the Mustangs shots have been a little long. And it was nice to see Steel Handy take a shot, because he's been open a lot of times, and you're gonna see this on the replay. Look at Roberts go up and just tip it up in the air. You don't see a lot of that on the prep level, and he made it look easy. Here comes a trap in the corner. Gives the Eagles a little bit of problems. Indeed, it's a turnover. Quickly, Matt Gonder coming up the court. With his left hand, crosses over. Just good footwork by the Eagles. They're keeping them out of the paint. And just as soon as I say that, you see Daniel Raymond get some great penetration, but again, can't find the range. This is the time for the Eagles to put this game away. But they've got a little bit cold too, although they do lead 17-2 after the tip in from Roberts. Decent look down. Raymond diving across the lane and scooping it up. He draws the foul, put himself on the line. He's got a little bit of it. Either knocked his knee or his hip. He'll be just fine, but it stings for just a minute. You're going to see right here, here comes the ball across. Tapped out to Raymond. He gets the quick penetration, gets his feet knocked up. Boy, it almost looks like he got a Charlie horse. Raymond misses the three. And you're gonna have nights like this, and the Mustangs are suffering through one right now, where the shots just aren't finding the bottom of the net. Crossover, picks up after the great defense. Steele pulls, misses long. Muir doesn't have numbers, hits across to Roberts with a nice move and up high off the glass. And that was a great look by Muir. And, you know, reward the big fella for running the court. Roberts comes crashing down the lane, and Muir finds him. Easy two-point basket. Lots of screens to the ball handlers from the Mustangs with 46 seconds left here in the second period. Boy, could have been anything. The ball gets stolen at middle court. Misses the three. And you can't say the Mustangs haven't had their looks tonight. And plenty of chances at and near the rim. Tonight's game brought to us by L&L Motor. People you know, people who care. Become a fan and like L&L on Facebook, and you can be entered into one of their drawings. I want to thank L&L and all the sponsors that bring us tonight's game. And here we're about 36 seconds away from halftime, so stick around for the Jiffy Pawn Shop, proud sponsor of the Strata WebView live stream. Watch it live at strata.tv. Excuse me, I was going to talk about the halftime show, and that's brought to us by Bigfoot Pro Shop, sponsor of high school basketball halftime performances. The Bigfoot Pro Shop, they've got you covered for all your outdoor adventures. 25 seconds left. Eagles are probably, nope, they're just going to get whatever shot presents itself. No, we've got a foul on the floor. Take the basket away from Roberts. See on the replay, here comes the quick swing, and then a look down. And Roberts, with a strong move, draws the foul on number 22, Alex Brady. 18 seconds left. Trapped in the corner. Give him a little breathing room. Got it up to Hamburg, who found Braxton Spencer. And now they look to play for the last shot. 6 seconds left. They got to make their move now. And there's the move. It could have been a travel. And it's going to go to Roberts at the buzzer. Misses. Well, at the half, the Duchesne Eagles lead the Manila Mustangs 19-2. Stick around for the Bigfoot Pro Shop halftime performance. Bigfoot Pro Shop, we've got you covered for all your outdoor adventures. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
Strata Networks offers advanced voice, internet, wireless, and TV solutions, all from a local company you know and trust. Bundle three or more qualifying services with Strata Networks and get 10% off. Start saving today.
On your way to the great outdoors, stop by Bigfoot Pro Shop on North Vernal Avenue. We've got you covered. Bigfoot Pro Shop. Just look for the giant fly in the sky.
Tired of fast food type financial planning, benefits, and insurance plans? At the Advisor Group, we have specialized teams for financial planning, retirement plans, health benefits, and insurance. That's why we're the big city firm of firms for your local and professional needs.
Petroleum may have changed their name to Pilot Logistics, but the employees that you have always counted on locally are still the ones here now. Pilot Logistics continues to provide the Uinta Basin with cardlock services, bulk fuels, lubes, and oils, just as they did when they were Western Petroleum. Call 789-1832 for information about the services offered by Pilot Logistics. Western Petroleum would like to thank all of their valued customers for the many years of providing services here in the Uinta Basin and look forward to serving you in the future as Pilot Logistics.
Ashley Regional Medical Center invites you to meet their new general surgeons, Dr. Trevor Mathis and Dr. Dennis Lewis. If you need a gallbladder surgery, a hernia repair, a biopsy, or a colonoscopy, the surgeons at Northeastern Utah General Surgery can help. Dr. Lewis has many years of experience in all types of general surgery. Dr. Mathis has recently completed his surgical residency and is trained in all the latest surgical techniques. Call today to set up an appointment.
High school sports coverage is provided by Ashley Regional, CrossFit Avenue, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, Pilot Logistics Services, and the Advisor Group.
With more towers locally and the only true 4G LTE network in the Uinta Basin, you get more with Strata Networks. Enjoy fewer dropped calls, the basin's fastest and most reliable network, nationwide coverage, and the latest technology that keeps you connected like never before. Visit us in Roosevelt or Vernal, or call us at 622-5007. More speed, more power. 4G LTE, only from Strata Networks.
Welcome back to the second half of the Duchesne Eagles leading Manila Mustangs 19-2. And it's been a run and gun for the Eagles. They're doing it outside, they're doing it inside. And the story of the night, of course, is the Mustangs just cannot find their range. They've had plenty of looks. All of them look long and strong, hard off the rim, and then the Eagles on the fast break just, you know, kind of putting their, forcing their will into this game. Well, I've brought Stan Young here tonight. Stan's the principal of Duchesne High School. Welcome, Stan.
Well, thank you. Glad to be here.
Yeah, thanks for coming. And, you know, when we come here, first of all, the facility's beautiful.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, we're really proud of it.
And the second of all, we get treated better here than all the other high schools that we cover combined.
Makes me happy. I'm glad to hear you say that.
And the administration, coaching staff really take care of us, and it's a fun place, and you guys play a really fun brand of basketball here. Now, I brought you on here, and I said it earlier on the telecast that I think the Duchesne Eagles is the high school. We should rename it Championship High.
Well, yeah, I mean, we've had a great run with a lot of things, and we're really proud of some of the things we're getting done right now. We have won a few championships, and it feels good. They never get old.
Yeah, it doesn't get old. You've got the high school football. Was it the fourth championship in a row? Am I correct there?
That's correct. Four football championships.
And then the drill team, I believe, just won their 10th championship in a row.
11, actually.
11. and we are counting, so make sure you don't miss that 11th. What is it? You know, you expect the athletes and the success to kind of go in phases. You know, you get a couple of standouts and you expect to compete those years. What is it that you do and the coaching staff that the school employs, what is it they do that demands such a high level of excellence from all the programs that operate here?
Well, you know, obviously it boils down to coaches, all the credit to coaches and our kids, because our kids buy into the idea that championships are possible, and if you work hard, they're entirely attainable. And if they listen to coaches and do what they're told and work hard, they've realized some success.
Yep.
And you know how when that gets going like that, that feeds itself.
Sure. So. Yeah, winning begets winning, right?
Exactly.
And the next generation says, I have to do it because those guys before me did it. And it's almost an expectation. You know, you talk about that belief system. You know, they've got to believe, but I think it's more than that. I think it's got to be a cultural, in the schools of the high school, you know, I haven't been here during a school day. Do the kids treat each other with respect? Do they treat the, you know, the teachers and the staff with respect? Is it just a complete cultural top to bottom that leads to this kind of success?
Well, I'll give you an example of that is, you know, we share our kids, and you know, a lot of places, a lot of schools will say, you're going to play basketball, and I don't want you doing other things, or your football. But it's not uncommon for us to have our kids walk off the football field from practice and walk directly to the auditorium for play practice. And so they're involved in the drama. They're involved in a lot of different areas. And so one of the things that we're really proud of, and a key to some success that we get, I think, is just because that's an expectation, and the kids know that they're welcome, and more than expectations is just that we want them to be able to do a lot of things. And we want our school to be excel at lots of things, and that's kind of what we're proud of. You know, we excel from our academics to out here on the floor, as you see. And so we have a lot of things going on that way. We actually scored higher than all but four schools in the state of Utah in secondary schools on the CRT testing last year.
And wow.
So, you know, those kinds of things just go hand in hand. If your kids are willing to put in that kind of time and sacrifice in the classroom, they'll do it out here as well.
Yeah, and you're talking, you hit kind of my core philosophy, the three A's of education: athletics, academics, and the arts. You know, and you need to be well-rounded at all three as a school and as an individual, and it sounds like the athletes are, you know, bought into that whole system. It's a pleasure to be here at the school. And Stan, I appreciate you spending a few minutes during the game to talk about that, because, you know, you just don't see this level of excellence that often. And I appreciate you sharing some of your insight and why you think that it's working that way for you.
Well, great. I'm always glad to talk about the Eagles.
Go Eagles. All right. Thanks a lot, Stan.
Thank you.
Well, that was fun. We had Stan Young, principal of the Duchesne Eagles, you know, talking about these kids, and, you know, what a cool thing, you know, off the football field, right in the auditorium for play practice. You know, well-rounded, good student athletes, and respectful, good sports as well. Always a pleasure to be here at the Duchesne Eagle High School. Well, you see there, the Mustang fans getting on their feet, trying to influence the shot. And here comes a little half-court trap. The Mustangs break it, get a nice three. It's partially blocked. And then saved, tried to knock off the Eagles out of bounds, but instead it leads to a fast break. And it could have been a charge, no call. Ball on the ground, it's a scrum. Who ends up with it? Here come the Mustangs. No numbers, they got one on five. He's got to recognize that. Takes the ball, gets knocked out of bounds. I believe it'll stay here with the Mustangs. And already the Mustangs finding a little bit more of that range. In the half, both teams have scored 3 points here in the early minutes of the third period. And the Mustang fans are bringing it right now. Mustang fans 1, Duchesne Eagle fans 0 at this point. But I think it's the scoreboard that matters. For a 3, and he knocks it home. Raymond can't find a hole, kicks it back outside. You know, you notice Spencer, he hits that three and he's the first guy back, and it's always that way. Big rebound, but then a bigger block by Spencer. Another block, but then they draw the foul. Boy, you'll see on the replay, if we can bring it up, Spencer, a one-man wrecking crew down there. Ball gets inside. Offensive rebound blocked. Another rebound. blocked, but he did get the arm on the second one. Missed the first free throw. Checking in. Steel Handy. Boy, the Mustangs have been just a little bit off all night. Matt Muir quickly across. The long, all the way across the court pass. Dangerous, not intercepted in that case. Down to Roberts, kicks out. Roberts banging down low, finds the open man. It's gonna be on the floor. Blake Jones got tied up. And already this period, four team fouls for the Mustangs and two for the Eagles. We've had more fouls called here in this third period than the first half combined. And that's the slower rate of pay. Oh, nice, just strength. Blake Jones gets the pass on the low block, and you can't allow on an inbounds play that ball to be entered into the low block. And then quickly the other way, Steel Handy with the jump stop. Jump stop stupid, and he gets it off the glass. Roberts answers on the other end. The bigs are going toe-to-toe here. And Roberts calling out the defensive assignments, but gets the block from behind. Boy, the intensity has certainly picked up. Both ends of the court going. Little head and shoulders fake, look down low, catches it off the glass, can't do anything with it, but then fouled, Blake Jones. They're gonna give him two shots. Well, I said, Mustang fans one, Duchesne Eagle fans zero. But if you look off my right shoulder, the Eagles have answered and are on their feet. Got their faces painted, got their jerseys on, and they're answering. They heard the call. Blake Jones misses the first, gets the second to go, 30-7. The Eagles lead the Mustangs. Tonight's game brought to us by Moon Lake Electric, in operation since 1938. Owned by the people they serve, Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned. Patience from the Mustang offense. Off screen, pick and roll, doesn't go, attacks. Ball knocked away, out of bounds on the Eagles. Good patience by Ben Rose. I thought he had a lane, but the quick hands of the Eagles just knock it out. Safely inbounds. Ooh, what a beautiful basketball play there by Jordan Saldana, but he can't get it to go. And then on the other end, Ben Rose comes up and pressures the ball right here at half court, knocks it out of bounds. He's hoping to get a call, but it stays with the Eagles. Saldana on the drive, up and under, two defenders, but can't get it off the glass to go. Pressure defense. Ooh. You'll see Matt Dye coming in off the screen. Here he comes down. He cuts to the lane and then goes to shoot. Fouled hard on the line, on the arm by Ben Rose, but with his strength, almost got it up and in. Short on the free throw. Both teams struggling a little bit from the line tonight. Dive for the second. This one's long. Missed the first one short. Overcompensated. Mustangs come up the court in a hurry. Look down. Little crossover. Hard to the rim. Oh, just misses it. Quickly up the court. Spencer passes it down. Fouled. I think Saldana gets the foul. I think it was Gatherum that was trying to get the shot off, and it is, he gets two. The Eagles are in the bonus for the rest of the game. Seven team fouls for the Mustangs, only two for the Eagles. for the first of two. Gatherum hits. Riemann comes in, spells Trent Roberts. Trent's been a beast tonight, doing it defensively and offensively. For the second, short, gets his own rebound. Three-pointer off the mark, but another offensive rebound for the Eagles. Dye kicks it out, swing, shot, short. Dye with another huge offensive rebound. Outside to Gatherum, he doesn't miss, nothing but net. Full timeout from the Eagles. We're going to take a short break and hear a word from our sponsors.
Moon Lake Electric has been a staple in the basin for 75 years, and though many things have changed through the years, one thing stays the same: our dedication to keeping the power on and our priority of doing that safely. We now have a Facebook page, which can be accessed through our website, allowing you to receive energy tips, outage reports, personnel changes, and feedback. Moon Lake Electric thanks its members and employees for 75 years of keeping the power on.
Well, we got the back here after the timeout, and you see the Duchesne Eagle fans are up on their feet. They answered the call. I honestly think they heard me. Maybe I need to go talk to them, give them a little more pep talk. I guess it's a little bit hard to get up when your team's... And we see an interesting call, full court press from the Eagles, even though they lead 34-7, and it leads to a foul. Gatherum comes in across and hits Ben Rose. I guess this is one of those times where the coach is saying to himself, let's not let him get back in. And we know the Mustangs can shoot. They just haven't had it tonight. It's been just an awful night for them from range. And I'm sure the thought process is, let's win now. Deep three, and he rattles it home. That's number five, Matt Gonder. Don't call it a comeback. He was never gone. Oh, and a block down low by Gonder. Gonder gets the rebound, and he's doing it all. Down low, and Gonder for another shot. He gets it, the and one. It's the Gonder show all of a sudden. Five straight points, looking to make it six. Boy, in the pass down low, Gonder catches it, and then he jumps up and away from the defender, forces the defender to hit him on the elbow, and then with strength puts it in, and he hits the free throw. Six straight points for Gonder. Boy, there's some strength down low. You see a battle going on. Steel Handy and number 40, Wyatt Riemann, and Handy wins that battle. Deep three, elects not to shoot it. And the Mustangs have come to life. Dribble drive by Rose, gets it up and gets the foul. Fifth team foul for the Eagles. And it puts Ben Rose up on the line. That was senior night tonight. The seniors playing their last game on their home court. Braxton Spencer, Alex Gatherum, Matt Muir, Matthew Dye, Trent Roberts, Quade Thomas, and Brandon Barson. That was the seniors. They delayed the game a little bit tonight to announce the seniors. And it seems like we've caught all the seniors. We caught it at, I believe, Uinta, Union, and now here tonight for the Duchesne Eagles. And you got a close-up view of the Manila Mustang fans going nuts. And that's a universal, cheerleading. They say something like, "Let me see your flying Mustang." What's that you say? Because we did that, boy, back when I was in high school, and this is a long time ago. I wonder if there's a cheerleading handbook of must-haves, you know, kind of the, you know, the gotta-haves chants, and then you might have some alternates, but you have to do these three. We'll have to ask somebody at that about that. Well, I managed to talk my way all the way through the break between the third and fourth period. Usually we would have gone to a commercial. Instead, we'll thank Pilot Logistics. Western Petroleum may have a new name, but we are still the same great company you can rely on, Pilot Logistics. ...34-13 here in the fourth. The Eagles will shoot free throws for the rest of the period, if fouled. The Mustangs still have two fouls before they get into the bonus. But the Eagles have two fouls to give. Penetration kick out. Short on the three-pointer. Rebound, Eagles, Trent Roberts. Outlet, they're looking up the court, they push. Swing it out, gather them, three off the mark. Oh, man, that one looked like it hurt. Ben Rose got up in the air, got hooked, and brought down hard, lands on his elbow. But like all 17-year-olds, he gets up like it didn't even affect him. You're going to see him come across, and he has the quick crossover and penetrates, gets up in the air, and gets hooked inadvertently by Blake Jones. And about 10 feet away from the scorer's table here, he just bounces off the hardwood. But the young blood gets right back up and shoots his free throws. And makes... 34-15. Mustangs came to life. I think it's going to be a little too little too late. 30-second timeout from the Eagles. We're going to take this opportunity to hear a word from our sponsors. We'll be right back.
Strata Networks offers advanced voice, internet, wireless, and TV solutions, all from a local company you know and trust. Bundle three or more qualifying services with Strata Networks and get 10% off. Start saving today.
We're back with this VTV production of high school basketball. The Manila Mustangs have come to life here in the second half, scoring in bunches, led by the power play of Matt Gonder. The defense is still handy. Ball handling of Jordan Saldana. Eagles with a 19-point lead. 7 minutes left. And suddenly the tide's in the favor of the Mustangs. But Roberts says, "I don't think so," and bangs down low and does it from the low block. He's such a load. So strong, it's hard to take that. We got a blocking foul. And I'll tell you right now, Braxton Spencer doesn't like that call. And anyone who knows who's tried to take a charge, how bad that hurts. You're gonna see the breakdown here. Ben Rose breaks him down, and it sure looks to me that Braxton Spencer was not only camped out, he'd cooked dinner and had a night's sleep by the time he got down there. Ben Rose makes him pay by hitting the first. and rattles the second home after a two-point first period. First half, they've scored 15. The Eagles have scored 17 since the break. A much closer second half. We knew the cold streak for the Mustangs couldn't last forever. Can they do any more damage? Long three goes down. Daniel Raymond. 16-point lead. And the pressure's now on the home team. Turnover. Here come the Mustangs. 6 minutes left. Not looking down the court, had a man open. What a nice penetration dribble drive just off the back of the rim. The Eagles look to run, they do. High off the glass, can't get it. Roberts, huge offensive rebound. Foul by Alex Brady. Roberts got so high for that rebound. You're going to see on the replay, Eagles pushing it up the court. And Roberts, the big fella, running up the court on this on the soft side. And look how high he goes up for that rebound. Reaches out with the right hand. Can't get it to go. Foul, Alex Brady. Timeout on the floor. We have a full timeout. We're going to step away and hear a word from our sponsors.
On your way to the great outdoors, stop by Bigfoot Pro Shop on North Vernal Avenue. We've got you covered. Bigfoot Pro Shop. Just look for the giant fly in the sky.
Tired of fast food type financial planning, benefits, and insurance plans? At the Advisor Group, we have specialized teams for financial planning, retirement plans, health benefits, and insurance. That's why we're the big city firm of firms for your local and professional needs.
Welcome back, everybody, to Duchesne High School, where the Eagles lead the Mustangs 36-20. And I'll tell you right now, we knew the Mustangs couldn't continue to shoot so poorly from the field, and they came to life. And Roberts, he's got an interesting tactic. It must be the way he shoots, because all of his free throws have hit the backboard. He's made a couple, and he's missed some. And he bangs home the second. And if it works, keep shooting it like that. Banker's hours are extended. Saldana drive, hits out. Raymond penetrates, doesn't get what he wants. Ben Rose, so dangerous with his crossover. Does it there, little hesitation. Gets where he wants to, shoots it high off the glass and does. 15-point lead. Just chipping away. Another turnover by the Eagles. Here come the Mustangs. Ben Rose, he's done it all night. Breaking down the defender, quick moves, does there, goes left to right, kicks out. Back out to Rose, he's the playmaker. What can he do? Double team, hesitation, gets the shot off. Off the glass. Picks up his own rebound. The jump stops, oh, and he banks it off the glass. It's Gonder, again, having a huge quarter. Looking for the foul, 13-point lead. Oh, and just a careless turnover, over and back. And the Mustangs are galloping back into this game. You see there, that's a miscommunication. Gatherum clearly thought Spencer was going to pop out for the pass. Spencer cuts down low and the ball just harmlessly rolls across the half court line for an over and back. Raymond looks, ball fake. Gonder Oh, blocked and then fouled. No foul. Excuse me, Braxton Spencer just knocks the ball out of bounds. Nice ball fake, but a quicker recovery by Spencer comes over and knocks the ball out of bounds. Gonder just off the mark. Roberts with a huge offensive rebound. Riemann brings it up the court, but another turnover. Mustangs with 4 minutes left, putting all the pressure in the world on the Eagles. Deep three, hits it. 10-point game.
We got a
timeout,
Manila.
Timeout, Manila on the court. Stay with us. We're going to take a short break and hear a word from our sponsors.
Western Petroleum may have changed their name to Pilot Logistics, but the employees that you have always counted on locally are still the ones here now. Pilot Logistics continues to provide the Uinta Basin with cardlock services, bulk fuels, lubes, and oils, just as they did when they were Western Petroleum. Call 789-1832 for information about the services offered by Pilot Logistics. Western Petroleum would like to thank all of their valued customers for the many years of providing services here in the Uinta Basin and look forward to serving you in the future as Pilot Logistics.
Welcome back to Duchesne High School, where the Manila Mustangs have made a game of it after trailing 19-2 in the first half. They got it rolling right now. The Eagles have been a little careless with the ball, not able to handle the higher pressure defense. They get a foul on the floor, 1-1. That puts Braxton Spencer on the line. And this is where you win ball games, folks, because the momentum has swung completely to the men in black right now. The home team has the pressure on him with the 1-1 up, and he makes it. Cool as the other side of the pillow. Braxton Spencer, nothing fazes him. Except for maybe the female fans from Manila. No, not even they can influence it. Extends the lead back out to 12 points. Three from Raymond, hits it! They're trading threes for twos. It's now a 9-point lead. Could have been a travel. Pressure defense. We got it on the line, foot on the line. Another turnover from the Eagles. Do you believe in miracles? The Manila Mustangs think so. Nice pass. Oh, block. And they do call the right call. Hit him on the arm. A steel hand, he went up high. The replay will show he got hit full on the forearm. Stopped the progress of the shot. So here's the penetration all night long. Ben Rose is giving him troubles. And there's the foul, and it was clear as day. Wyatt Riemann hit the arm of the shooter off the back of the iron. They can't afford these misses right now. Handy's got to gather himself and make this. The Manila fans, hands in the air. Can Handy do it? Misses again. Gets him. No, doesn't get his own rebound. Bounces off his arms. Quickly to Braxton Spencer. He directs the offense. 9-point lead. They've got to take time off every possession. Roberts posting up like an animal. Up high. Blocked. They give a foul. I can't believe it. Gonder had his hand on top of the ball. You'll see on the replay, look at Roberts says, I want this, I want to win. Gunner got the left arm before he got to the ball. It was the right call. Roberts misses the first, 39-30, 2:48 left in the period. can't get the second one to go. Big rebound. Lost out of bounds. Boy, I thought Wyatt Riemann came up with just a miracle rebound down low. Couldn't keep the handle, and here comes the Mustangs down by nine. We knew the cold spell couldn't last forever. Although I had my doubts. Raymond, dribble drive, can't get it. Guess who does? Ben Rose outside, long three, can't made. Steele doesn't get the rebound, Roberts does. Eagles quickly. Penetration, and then he thought better of it. Gatherum comes back out, swings it around, down low, Roberts, turnover. Ben Rose, the ball, 2 minutes left, they've got to do it here. Gets the penetration he wants, high off the glass and in, 7-point game. Here come the Eagles, 1:55 left. Gatherum in the corner, swings it out. Roberts charges in like a bull. He's going to go to the line. I believe the foul goes against Steele Handy. Good, quick ball movement from the Eagles. See the opening. Here comes Roberts. And sure enough, Handy wasn't quite set and reached out with the left knee and tripped up Roberts. 7-point lead. Off the glass and in. 8-point lead, 1:45 left. Roberts again, banks it off the glass. Guess who comes up with the rebound? Wyatt Riemann, the sophomore, hustles again. Somehow squeezes between two Mustangs and comes up with the ball. You'll see he comes from the left side of the formation and he dives down, quick anticipation, maybe a half step early. But they gotta know they're crashing down. Gotta get to that. He makes the first 9-point game. Misses the second. Rose with the rebound. He says, it's mine. I'm gonna do what I do. Oh, and Roberts saves what would have clearly been a 2-point play by Gonder. Quick hustle and the quick hands knocks it out of bounds. Saldana with the ball. Waiting, Rose here on the left side. Raymond for a three, short. Big time rebound off with the left hand. Matt Gonder, he's having a heck of a ball game. Oh, and they got the foul. I don't agree with it, neither does the head coach, Rusty Burnside. Ben Rose comes over and he puts the dangerous Braxton Spencer, who's hit a lot of his free throws, and you look, nothing fazes the kid. He could be getting a Slurpee at the 7-Eleven from the look on his face. Takes his time and swishes it. Eight-point game, 1:19 left. Long, Raymond with the rebound. Up to Ben Rose, we got a timeout. We got a technical. Oh, and just a crazy, how can you have a meltdown like that? I think the technical is gonna go against Braxton Spencer right here. Oh, Trent Roberts, after the timeout was called, put his right arm out and gave Ben Rose the cold shoulder. Gives Rose two free throws. Rose misses the first. Boy, and you just can't make those kind of mistakes. Not with a game where all the momentum swung to the Mustang side, and he rattles in the second. It's a free point. And now we're looking at that was the technical, and then they'll bring him back for the 1-1. 9 team fouls for the Duchesne Eagles, 10 for the Manila Mustangs. So from here out, they'll both be in the double bonus. Yeah, you see right here, the timeout's called right there. And then Rose continues his drive, and Roberts foolishly puts his right arm out and hits Rose. Boy, those are the kinds of things that cost you ball games, folks. 7-point game. It might be too little too late for the Manila Mustangs. Who knows? 7 points is not an insurmountable lead, especially with the emotions swinging the way they have. The Mustangs have all the confidence right now, and it's the Eagles who look shaken. Midway through the third period, they look like they have this ball game under control. Score was 22-5 midway through the third period. And now look what's happened. 42-35, Rose with the ball. He's the guy. He's broken down the defense all night, shading him to his left side. 3-pointer up, short. And quickly up. Look who has it, Matt Muir. He does a little okey-doke and gets it to go. And then Muir puts the pressure on Rose coming up the court. 9-point game. Hits it back out. Give it back to Rose. 3, short. Roberts with the big board. Gatherum brings the ball up. He's going to have patience, and they should. They have to get fouled. Keep it with your shooters. No foul yet. Gatherum gets through, and then the foul. Saldana with the foul. Push from behind. 32 seconds left. It looks like the Mustang rally is going to fall just a little bit short. But what heart from the kids from Manila. And what you would almost call a laugher. Only scoring 2 points in the first half. They never quit. Heart as big as lions. Gatherum hits the first with the soft left hand. 10-point game. And that'll probably seal it, folks. 11-point game. Rose has the ball. Looks up the court. Oh, there's the foul. We see on the substitution, number 33, Brandon Barson coming in, one of the seniors tonight. He gets his first foul. Handy up off the left side of the iron. The struggles from the free throw line continue for the Mustangs. Coach Burnside calls his charges aside and says, this game's not over, keep fighting. Down 11, they gotta do it quick. Rattles out the second. Roberts gets fouled. That's probably the guy on the court you wanna foul. He takes his time bringing it up the court. Off the glass, misses the first. I want to thank the sponsors that helped bring us this game tonight. The Advisor Group, CrossFit Avenue, Ashley Regional, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, and Pilot Logistics. Sponsoring the live stream was Jiffy's Pawn Shop, and the halftime performance, which ended up being a bunch of kids shooting three-pointers, the Bigfoot Pro Shop. Raymond with a nice strong move and gets it to go. Cuts it back down to a 9-point lead, 11 seconds left. Eagles throw it full court, kick it out to Roberts, comes in hard and gets fouled. 4.8 seconds left. Roberts and Saldana exchange pleasantries and email addresses so they can send each other Christmas cards. Roberts looks like a Marine. Shoots like a cannon. Misses the first. Misses the second. We got a foul. Number 33, Brandon Barson, sends the Mustangs to the other side with 3.4 seconds left. I'm not sure if Saldana. They're going to have Saldana shoot it. He's got two. They've cleared the line. Misses the first off the front of the iron. Makes the second. That's almost like a technical possession and the shots and possession. Although I didn't see what the call was. 8-point lead, 3 seconds left, it's over. Rose is gonna look to get a half court shot. Up, hard off the glass, no good. Heck of a ball game, folks. After leading 19-2, the Mustangs said, we're not quitting tonight. Came storming way back into this game. Cut the lead as little as 7 and end up losing by 8 on the Eagles' home court tonight. And I'm telling you, the action was fast and furious. And the Eagles probably feel a little fortunate tonight that they didn't, that the Mustangs didn't start their charge sooner. What an entertaining game. I appreciate everyone that watched live on the Strata WebView broadcast there on strata.tv. I want to remind everyone that you can get DVD copies of tonight's game. Go to vtvchannel6.com or call 781-1902 for your copy today. I want to thank the, well, before that, we have one game left. Join us February 26th. That's next Wednesday night, Duchesne at Altamont. And then we may have some state basketball coverage. VTV now owns the rights to 3A playoff coverage. So look for that on the website. And we'll try to announce it on the rebroadcasts as we rebroadcast these games. I want to thank the credits, the camera and crew. Camera operators, Danny McKenna, Kobe Coonrad, Kobe Waite. Graphics, Dave Ryan. Audio and instant replay, Tyler Rasmussen. Network engineer and live stream, Brent Simmons. Director, producer, Devin Allred. I'm Mark Mason. I appreciate you all for tuning in all season long and tonight. Have a great night, folks.
These high school sports coverage is provided by Ashley Regional, CrossFit Avenue, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, Pilot Logistics Services, and the Advisor Group.